Welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. I'm in my car. I am headed into my real estate office to attend my virtual WW workshop. I go there on Fridays because my husband is off and I don't want to wake him up by talking. And then of course I have to film my weigh-in results and recap of the workshop for you guys. And I just feel bad if I'm in our house talking and filming and waking him up. So I just head to the real estate office. Not to mention, I cannot upload videos from my house. I don't think that I've ever mentioned that, but I live out of town a little bit, kind of in the country, and my internet is fantastic other than uploading videos. A video that takes me 5 to 10 minutes at the real estate office takes me 3 hours at my house. So I generally have to leave and drive in to town a little bit to upload my video. So since I have to do that, I figured why not just do these virtual workshops at my real estate office. So I'm heading in there now so that I'm ready to go and see all my WW friends. I'm actually really enjoying the virtual workshops. I will try to get a little bit of a snippet of the workshop for you if I can, without like looking like a creeper with my camera during the workshop. So I'll see if I can get a little snippet for you guys. But I wanted to hop on really quick and say good morning and let you guys know kind of how my week went. I had a pretty darn good week. Now, the last couple days, I've been a little more hungrier than normal, but that's because I'm getting close to my favorite time. And I think that that's why my hunger has spiked a little bit. But I had a pretty good week. I did jazzercise twice, I think. I didn't do it as many times because we've been doing a lot of spring cleaning and my body's been tired from all the running around and spring cleaning, and I'm still not done. I have to clean all the blinds in my house still. So that'll be happening this weekend and maybe doing some things out in the yard, but still getting in my jazzercise, still staying on plan, still really trying during this time to focus on the one thing that I can control, and that's my WW plan. There's a lot of things right now that we can't control, and for me, my WW plan is something that I can, so I've really been focusing on that. So I'm gonna head out, get to the office, get set up for the virtual workshop, and I'll be back to share what we talked about, my weigh-in. We'll talk about kind of working WW right now, and I have some tips and tricks for you guys, and I'll see you after my workshop and my weigh-in. On a run from my given disaster, speed away from the holy mind.
Chuck, you do not have your video on. Did you
want to
turn it on?
Hi, friends. Welcome back. I just finished my virtual workshop, as you saw. It's actually not bad at all. I just miss seeing everybody in person. That's the only part that's not as great about the virtual workshops. But I do very, very much appreciate WW allowing us to do this and still stay connected and get all the valuable information that they share at the workshops. This workshop was exceptionally great. And it was talking about creating a new routine, creating a new normal. And this is something that I've talked about in a few of my videos. At this time, with everything kind of up in the air of what's going to happen in the future, how long are we going to be at home? How long are our favorite shopping stores, workshops, gyms, salons going to be closed? It's time that we have to really think about creating a new routine, something that we can stick with during the transition between our old routine and what will be our new regular routine once everything passes. So that was the topic today. There was some great information shared. So of course I want to share with you some of the information WW gave us, as well as kind of my own thoughts and feedback on the subject. So first we have to create new structure, a new routine. And to do that, we have to decide what is important to us. What are some of the key things that are important to us? For example, they may be things such as food or your diet program, your lifestyle program. It may be your family, your work, and what about exercise? So with those four components, how do you figure out what to do with them to create a new routine? So let's start first about food, because that is something that we struggle with. That's why we're here at WW. So what do you do in this time to create a new routine with food? So some suggestions that I have as far as food goes is continue to eat what you've always eaten and on the schedule that you've always eaten those foods on. Don't bring foods into your house that you don't have any control over or that you struggle with portion size. Make sure that you're doing exactly what you did
prior to all of this. Do that same routine when it comes to food. Meal plan, meal prep. We have extra time on our hands now because we can't go do all the fun shopping and things that we did before. So take advantage of this time. And if you haven't already, or if it's something you struggle with, start meal planning and meal prepping. Figure out what you're gonna make for the week so that when you go grocery shopping, you're bringing in those healthy foods. Plan your meals, prep some of your meals. If you don't wanna do the whole meal, maybe prep your veggies or your meats for the week so that it just makes staying on track a little bit easier. The food is where we can really get ourselves into trouble. So I know for me, I just can't bring those foods into my house because if I'm hungry or think that I'm hungry, those are the foods that I'm reaching for. So continuing my normal, which is meal planning, meal prepping, doing my grocery shopping as normal, really helps me stay on track and feel like this is still a normal routine for me. Continue to do your exercise. And I know it's hard, you guys, trust me. I know it's hard with all of the gyms and my beloved Jazzercise being closed. It's hard, one, to find activity to do that you love as much as the one you did before, and two, finding the motivation to continue doing that activity. There are so many activity options online, so many gyms, yoga studios, Jazzercise, like you name it, they've been offering free or reduced cost online workouts. You can even go here on YouTube and find free workouts. So for me, I've been doing my Jazzercise on demand. Even if I didn't go and pay for the monthly membership to Jazzercise, I would still do something online. I literally, you guys, set my laptop up in my mudroom, grab my weights or water bottles, whatever I have on hand, because I ordered weights, but they're not here yet. And I grab those, I put on my workout clothes, my tennis shoes, and I do all the things I did when I actually attended Jazzercise. That creates a new normal and a new routine for me. So if you don't have the option to do an online workout, clean your house. Do work in your yard. The weather is getting better for most of us. Be outside, do some yard work, some spring cleaning. Do all the things that you didn't have time to do before. And guess what? You still get activity points for all of those. It still counts as activity. So take advantage of this downtime and try to get in just a little more activity than you would when you're working and running all the errands and shuffling kids to and from school. Take advantage of this time to really bump up your activity. Also, family, spend a little extra time with your family. Have a family game night. Spend a little extra time with yourself. Do some self-care, some face masks, some bubble bath. Paint your nails, your toenails. Do a little bit of extra family time and self-care time. All the things that we put on the back burner because we're so busy with all of the other pieces of life. And right now, this is the best time to take advantage of spending a little extra time with our family and a little extra time even with ourselves. And what about work? For those of you that are working at home like myself, you have to set up a routine with work as well. Take breaks, just like you would if you were in the office. Take a lunch break. End your workday at a certain time. Commit to yourself to start work at one time and end it at another. And take the same breaks as you would if you were in the office. Set up a new routine with work at home. And I know it's hard. I know it's hard to work at home. Sometimes you just lack that motivation to do all those things at home. But take advantage of it and set yourself up a new schedule. Another thing with that, you guys, is get up, get ready for the day. Brush your hair, brush your teeth, put your makeup on. Get out of your pajamas because pajamas equal relaxation. And you're not gonna be as motivated to get things done during the day if you're in your pajamas. So get out of your pajamas, put your clothes on, get yourself all prettied up like you would if you were heading to work or running some errands. I promise you, you're going to feel a lot better and you're going to be a lot more productive. So the second piece to creating a new routine is adapting your outside activities. Like, did you go to happy hour once a week with all your friends? Or did you have spa days with your family or your friends on the weekends? And unfortunately, right now, we just can't do those things. So try to adapt new activity. This whole virtual Zoom, Skype, FaceTime thing, take advantage of that. Have weekly FaceTime, Skypes, Zooms with your friends. Zoom is free. You can get a whole group together like we do with the WW workshops. Do a Zoom virtual meetup every single week with your friends or your family. Try to stay connected virtually, but also physically, like be able to see the person that you're talking to and engage with the person where you feel like you're one-on-one with them a little bit more than on the phone or texting. So do take advantage of these online services that are free to stay connected with your friends and your family. I know it's not the same as going out for a burger and a beer with your buddies, but at least you get to see them, interact with them, and you feel a little bit more like things are normal. And lastly, stress. When we're stressed, a lot of us will eat. Overeating is very, very common during this whole entire ordeal. In fact, I saw a meme on Facebook where it said the quarantine 15. Like people are just anticipating to gain 15 pounds during the quarantine. Don't be one of those people, you guys. Set some boundaries when it comes to eating. Close the kitchen at a certain time. I mentioned this last week. I close the kitchen 1/2 hour to 1 hour after I finish dinner. I like to close my kitchen by about 6 o'clock. I generally eat dinner between 5 and 5:30, and I close my kitchen. That way I'm not tempted to overeat. Also, just don't bring those things into the house. It's really hard to go out and buy them. So if you're at the store, just don't buy them. Don't bring them into the house, and then you're going to be a little less tempted to eat those things. Continue to drink your water. We're at home. It's very easy, and water is very accessible. So continue to drink water. Just drink more than you've ever drank before, because it's right there. It's accessible, and it gives you something to do while you're watching TV or cleaning the house. And really just focus on your water. And lastly, continue to weigh in. Don't let the scale go. If you are someone that weighs in once a week at your workshop or for your online WW membership, don't let that routine go. Continue to weigh in. Not only is it going to keep you on track during the week, it's going to keep you motivated, and it's going to keep you from gaining the quarantine 15. So those are the tips from WW on how to kind of create a new routine. I have implemented a lot of these items myself, and you guys, I'm not saying this is easy. It's not. There are days that I just want to skip my online jazzercise because I don't have anybody meeting me at the class. I don't have an instructor expecting me. I'm not physically getting into the car and driving to the class and completing the class. I have to have enough self-motivation to get my laptop, grab my workout clothes, and go do my jazzercise on demand. I know it's hard, you guys. I know creating a new routine is hard when we're so set in our old routine. I know that stress during this time can be really, really hard on us. And we just have to try to focus on what is positive. We are here for you. I'm here for you guys. My Facebook group, here on YouTube, watch videos, get inspiration and motivation to stay on track. There are so many outlets for us for use of our time when we're stuck at home. Spend extra time with your kids or your family that you don't get to do on a regular basis because you're so busy with the other facets of life. So just focus on what you have that's positive right now and create a new routine that works for you. That's really the part that's changed the most. And that's the part that for me, I'm struggling with. You know, I miss my friends and family as much as the next guy. So just get a new routine going. I'm gonna be working on that again this week. But like I mentioned before I came in here for the workshop, is my food's been pretty good. I've been a little bit extra hungry, but I know why. I know why. So other than that, I've been focusing on routine, continuing to do jazzercise on demand. I actually, in my planner, scheduled jazzercise on demand for myself 3 days a week. That way, I can't skip it. It's in my planner. It's right in my face when I'm looking to plan my day. So my goals this next week is to do my jazzercise 3 times a week and continue my new normal, my new routine. And with that being said, you guys, I got on the scale this morning and I lost 1.2 pounds. So the last 2 weeks of this new normal, I've lost 1.2 pounds each week for a total of 2.4. I'm so excited about that. I am going to put March's weight loss total here on the screen for you. And I can't tell you guys how incredibly proud of myself that I am, that I've been able to lose weight during this really stressful, abnormal time. I have goals to continue to do that. In fact, today I just entered into a new weight decade, so that's very exciting for me. Gets me motivated to take off the next whatever pounds to get into the next weight decade. So set yourself some fun goals during this time, weight loss related, routine related, and just create a new normal and a new routine for yourself. So this next week, I have Jazzercise goals, continuing to track my food, stay on plan, do a little bit of extra activity around the house, like I mentioned, some spring cleaning, some yard work, and just, again, working this new routine that I'm slowly but surely creating. So before I go, I want to ask you guys how you're doing. I hope that everyone is doing well. I hope that you're able to create a new normal and a new routine for yourself. And I just want to remind you that I am here for you guys with any questions, concerns. Definitely support us over on YouTube. I've noticed that myself, and I've heard from other YouTubers that we're not getting the views on our videos that we used to. And that is bizarre to me because most of us are at home, so what better time to take advantage of watching YouTube? So I'm not sure why that's happening, but support us. We're putting content out there for you. There's a lot of us that are putting videos out daily to give you something to watch, to keep you inspired and motivated. So if you can support us, I know myself and the other YouTubers greatly appreciate that. So down in the comments, let me know how you guys are doing, how your week went. Did you gain? Did you lose? How are you doing with this new routine? And if you're new to my channel, make sure you're subscribed and your bell notification is turned on. Like I said, I'm uploading daily to give you guys inspiration and fun videos to watch. So make sure you're subscribed and your notification is turned on. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you love these weigh-in videos, give it a big thumbs up. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Hang in there. I love you. Bye, guys.